What's up, everyone? Today, I want to talk about why the trade war is hurting Chinese corporations more than their American counterparts. In 2018, Apple sold 225 million phones worldwide. But where the 225 million phones were made is hard to answer. An Apple iPhone is made up of more than 500 parts that are made in thousands of factories in dozens of countries around the world. Of Apple's top 200 core suppliers in 2019, 46 are from Taiwan, 40 from the United States, 39 from Japan, 30 from mainland China, 14 from South Korea, and 10 from Hong Kong, according to the latest figures. The remaining suppliers are located in Germany, Singapore, the Netherlands, Finland, and Austria. So behind an Apple iPhone is a global industrial chain. In fact, every iPhone has traveled most of the world before it reaches the hands of consumers. And from the layout of an Apple iPhone's industrial chain, we can see that global trade has undergone fundamental changes in the past two decades. Not long ago, Huang Qifan, vice chairman of China Center for International Economic Exchange, also expressed his views in a speech on the changes in the pattern of international trade. Huang Qifan mentioned that in the 1980s, 70% of global trade was in final manufactured goods, that is, the final commodity. Slowly, the situation began to change. In 2010, only 40% of global trade was in final manufactured goods, and the other 60% in intermediates. By 2018, the share of intermediates continued to rise, with more than 70% of global trade belonging to intermediates and only 30% to final manufactured goods. Intermediate products are divided into two categories. The first is various parts. The second is trade in services, including productive logistics, producer services, industrial chain finance, a variety of scientific and technological research and development. In other words, services catered to the corporations. Of these, trade in services accounted for about 5% of global trade in the 1980s, but had accounted for 30% of global trade by 2018. This is the fundamental change that has taken place in the global trade landscape. So under this new pattern, which companies will become the dominant rulers of global trade? Again, take Apple, for example, which consists of hundreds of components and involves dozens of professional manufacturers in dozens of countries. So Apple doesn't own all the patents on Apple iPhones, because all of these thousands of companies may have patents, but Apple is the ruler of this industrial chain. Because Apple is the company that sets the standards, all companies that serve Apple must meet Apple's standards while being innovative and patented independently. But if a company has a core technology related to smartphone but doesn't sell it to Apple, would Apple stop production? Well, the point is, Apple is one of the biggest mobile phone sellers in the world. And if Apple doesn't use the company's technology, that company could be the first to go bust. And Apple can choose other companies that owns the same technology. From this point of view, in order to become a global leader in an industry, a company should not only rely on core technology and capital, but also obtain the ability to control the industrial chain. In the 2 years of trade friction between China and the United States, Chinese companies have suffered more than American companies. Many people will wonder why China is so passive and eager to end the trade war, even if China is clearly the world's largest manufacturing country, producing 60% of the world's consumer goods. This is because in a new pattern of global trade, Chinese corporations do not master the core technology in the manufacture of many parts and components. More importantly, in a global industrial chain, Chinese corporations are not the standard makers and controllers. Therefore, if today's Chinese corporations want to form their own competitiveness, they must work from two aspects. First, at the level of parts, master the core technology. Second, they need to become the standard setters, which is also the focus of the industrial transformation of Chinese corporations. It is very difficult, but it is the strategic goal that Chinese corporations want to achieve over the next 10 or 20 years. It is because of this strategic disadvantage that China wants a trade deal more than the US.